Is a square a rectangle? Is a rectangle a square? If you had all of these questions in your mind, today they will be answered with the help of the Liskov Substitution Principle, a principle from the solid principles. I'm Alex from Rebeloper.com, and if you do want to learn all about this, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. Now let's open up Xcode and let's dive in. Liskov Substitution Principle. This is what we are going to tackle today. But before we dive into that, let me remind you about rebeloper.com/mentoring, a 60-minute Zoom call with me where you can ask me questions, whether it's bugs in your code or you would like to learn Swift UI or Swift, go ahead and check out rebeloper.com/mentoring. And because it's the new year, we are going to have a game on our channel. So this is what you have to do to win one mentoring with me. You have to, first of all, subscribe to the channel. If you haven't done so, that's a shame on you. So subscribe, like this video, and share it. And then the final is to comment down below in the comment section. So four things: subscribe, like, share, and comment down below. And in the next video, I will pick a random winner from all of you that did all of these four things. So go ahead and do that if you do want to win one mentoring session with me. And make sure to check out the next video, so where I pick out the lucky winner from you guys. Okay, so Liskov Substitution Principle. Now, what is the Liskov Substitution Principle? And that is one of the principles from the solid principles. And we have covered the first two, single responsibility and open-close principles. Go ahead and check out the link in the description for the whole playlist where you can take a look at them. Now we are going to tackle the Liskov Substitution Principle, which is part of the solid principles of K, of course. Now, why do you want to adopt the solid principles, you might ask? Well, because it solves bad architecture like fragility, immobility, and rigidity. Now, the principles establish practices that lend to developing the software with considerations for maintaining and extending as the project grows. So you are not writing this according to these code principles just because, you are writing for your future self. Now, the first one was the single responsibility principle. We talked about that. Go ahead and check out the link in the description for the playlist. Then open-close principle came. And finally, we are at Liskov Substitution Principle. Now, it states, objects should be replaced with instances of their subclasses without altering the behavior. Now, this is the short version. Here's a much longer version. If S is a subtype of T, then objects of type T may be replaced with objects of type S without altering any of the desirable properties of the program. Now, again, this is encrypted for now, but we are going to dive into an example. So let's just do that. Let's open up our Xcode project. And if you haven't already done so, there's a link in the description for the resources where you can download the resources for this series. And basically, we have all of these folders with a before and after file. Okay, so let's start off with the before file here. And let's just build up kind of an example which doesn't adhere to the Liskov Substitution Principle. And we are going to start off with building out a rectangle and calculating its area. So I'm going to create a file private function class here, and this will have a width and a height, of course. So let's just have it right over here. Let me just have a lot more space so we can type out all of our code efficiently. So width, that would be a float, and let's just set it to 0 by default so we don't have to bother with initializers. And let's have a height also of float, and that's equals also 0. Now, when we set the width and the height, we are going to have some functions for that. So func and self.width equals our input width. And we are going to do the same for the height. So let me just copy that out and paste it in, change it to height. And again, set height equals height. Okay, so that is how we are setting our width and height. And finally, let's have a function, and that will return a float. Okay, and let's just return here width and multiplied by height. Okay, so this is reasonable. Okay, this is good code. By the way, everything here is good code. It works, but if you don't adhere to these principles, you will have a lot of troubles on the long run. Okay, so that is why actually you want to adopt all of these. Now, let's say, you have our rectangle, so let's create a square here. So again, a fly private class, and then we want to override, because this is a square, it has equal size, so we want to override our width and height function. So maybe set width, there we go, it's just auto-completing it, and you might go like setting the width to the actual width, and also setting the height also to that input width. Okay, and let's do the same for the set height function. Let's override it, and self dot height equals height, and then self dot width equals width. Okay, this is fine. This looks okay. We don't really see the problem right over here, but let's just have a fly private using a fly private function using all of this. So let's just have a fly private func, and let's call it set size, and let's just print out the area. So set size and print area. And we want to add in here a rectangle, so of rectangle of type rectangle. Okay, and what we are going to do here is just go rectangle dot set, and let's just set the height, for example, let's set this to 5, and then we just go rectangle dot set the width of maybe 4, and then we just print out our rectangles calculate area. Okay, so that's great. This looks okay. But what if we had another function that uses also a rectangle and also a square? So a rectangle and also a square. So let's have that fly private func example function that I'm talking about, and this is where it all starts to get kind of not good. So let's create our rectangle, and that equals a rectangle, simple rectangle, and then set size and print area of our rectangle. Okay, this works fine, and actually this will print, let's just go over here, and prints 20. Okay, so it will just print out 20. But what happens if we just have let square equals our square, and then of course we can also set size and print of area, because square is actually a rectangle, that's how we define it, and let's just have a square here. And actually this is where you might want to touch the essence of the Liskov Substitution Principle, because this would actually print out 16. So why is that? That is because we have first set the height to 5, and then we set the width to 4. And that's not the way it should be. Why doesn't it print out maybe 20? Why is it exactly 16? So this is where it all gets hazy. So if we do have, and by the way, we can have this function. So if we can have this function, this breaks the Liskov substitution principle. So we shouldn't be allowed to even create this kind of function. So what to do instead? Well, let's just go into our after function, after file right over here, and let's rephrase our rectangle and square approach. Now, instead of creating a rectangle, we would create a protocol. So this is where protocols come in, and go ahead and check out the link in the description where I detail everything about protocols that you need to know in that video. Okay, so let's create a protocol that will encompass the square and the rectangle. So let's name this protocol polygon. And if you take a look at that video, you will see that protocols are kind of like polygon, are kind of like these contracts. So this polygon contract will require everybody who adheres to this contract to have a function called calculate area. Okay, now and this will just go return a float. Go ahead and check out the video on protocols if you don't really understand what I'm doing here with the protocol. And that's it, we created our protocol. Now it's time to create our classes. So first of all, I want to create a rectangle. So file private class rectangle. Okay, and this adheres to the polygon protocol. What this means is that we must add in here the calculate function, so we must adhere to it. And for that, I will have to have width and height. So var width, and that is of type float equals zero. Let's have a default var height, again of type float equals zero. And the area will just return, calculate area will just return width multiplied by height. Okay, and we can also have here a function called set width, and this will just go self and width equals width. And now let's just do the same for our height. Okay, let's just have height right over here. There we go. Okay, so yeah, let's just hit Command B so that error goes away. And we are done with our rectangle polygon. Now, let's create our square polygon. So this will be different. So let's create a file private square of type polygon. Where it is? Polygon. There we go. Because we adhere to the polygon protocol, we need to add, of course, our... Oh, sorry, not that one, but file private. Oh, I need to add in here class first. And then we need to adhere to the calculate area. So what I will do, let's just add in that function for now. And let's just have our width and height added. But actually, we are not going to do name it as width and height. We are actually going to go with a side, because squares only have sides. So let's have that as a float, and let's set this to zero. And then we want to have a function, and that will go self.side equals side. Now you kind of get to see the difference here. Here we are going to return bow and side squared. Okay, so now you see the differences between those two. If we want to print out the area, now we are going to create that file private function that prints out our area. So let's just name this func print area. Okay, here we want to actually file private, yeah, we need to add a space here, add a polygon, and we want to go print our polygons calculate area. Okay, and now let's create our example function. So again, file private func. Now it's time to create our rectangle and our square. And this is where it all shines, that you cannot actually make the confusion between those two. So let rectangle equals our rectangle. Okay, next we just go rectangle dot set width of 5, and then rectangle dot set sorry, not width, but set height. Set the height, there we go, 4. And then we just go print area of our rectangle. And this will actually prints 20, which is how it's supposed to be, which we are expecting. Now let's create our square. Square equals square. And now we can just simply add a square set. And all we have here, and this is the important part, all we have here and only one thing that we have here aside. And let's just set this to 4 and then just print area of square. And this prints 16, what it should do. So yes, that is the Liskov substitution principle, one of the 5 principles in Solid. Now, if you do like these types of videos, go ahead and check out rebeloper.com/mentoring, where you can meet me on a one-on-one Zoom call. And don't forget about January's game. Go ahead and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already done so. Like this video, share it with somebody you want to share it to, and then comment down below. It's very important so I can pick one of you guys to be a winner of a 1-hour mentoring session. Looking forward to your comments down below about the Liskov substitution principle. Now, if you do like these types of videos, make sure to smash that like button. And while you are at it, go ahead and hit that notification bell to get notified of new videos. New videos like the next one in our series, and that is about the interface segregation principle. And if you do like this, go ahead and check out also the playlist. Looking forward to your comments, and as usual, I will see you in the next one.